You know, even when I was a kid, we always had a stock dog of some kind around here, and usually it was a blue heeler, and you know, they knew how to chase stuff, but they didn't know how to stop, and that, you know, that was about it. If you wanted help chasing something, they were all it. And several years ago, we were arguing with some sheep, and sheep were so hard to contend with if you didn't have a good stock dog, that we just finally bit the bullet and went and bought a finished dog. In hindsight, she wasn't a great dog, but compared to what we're used to, it was like a whole new world opened up to you. Well, pretty soon we bought a second one, and then we thought, hey, you know, everybody needs one of these things. So we started raising a few and training a few and doing some trialing. They were just so darn handy to have around. We had quite a few dogs around here at one time, and then it just got to be so time consuming trying to train dogs and start dogs, and man alive, it turned into a bigger project than you could really do. So, you know, we don't raise a lot of dogs anymore. We breed some dogs, and generally I get pick of the litter when we do that, and that's how we get young dogs now, rather than trying to raise litters of our own. Boy, all in all, top to bottom, they're about as good a stock dog as you stumble across, I think, for our neck of the woods. One thing I really like about border collies, you can teach an old dog new tricks. I mean, they're sharp. They figure that out pretty quick. And I just don't think you're ever done training on them. It always amazes me how these dogs learn the routine. You know, particularly in the fall when you're starting to feed, you know, and the routine changes a little bit from year to year. It may not be drastic, but it's different pens, different things. And usually by the third day, the dog's waiting for me at the right gate.